distinguished young woman of Triton. My parents are Ken and Nancy Miller.
I have in my hands the list of the 10 finalists. Are we ready? These are in no particular order. This is what they've been working for all week. The first of our finalists, number 15, Morgan Hayes. Participant number 7, Victoria Homer. Participant number 10, Lauren Ehrman. Number 2, Nicole Gavin. Participant number 16, Courtney. Participant number 22, Sarah. Participant number 5, Samantha. Participant number 8, Lauren McClaskey. Participant number 11, Rebecca Carson. And our final finalist, contestant number 12, Alexis Miller. A nice round of applause. Narrow this down. There can only be one distinguished young woman for Indiana 2016, and the contest to determine who that will be will begin in just a few minutes. Ladies, you'll see me back on stage in just a few minutes. through the pain. By the way, that was designed by Keaton Whirlin, who is the son of Julian Kent, who's a circus performer, incidentally. It's on YouTube. If any of you want to learn to do it, go to YouTube. Let me know how that works out for you. I watched it once. It's pretty impressive. After 8 years of piano lessons taught by a fantastic teacher, Lexi has gained valuable knowledge that has applied to all areas of her life. She learned how to perform in front of an audience, prioritize her schedule, sing in tune, and keep a steady beat. Lexi chose to play Fur Elise tonight because it was one of the most recognizable pieces of music in history and because it's fun to play. Let's welcome contestant number 12, Lexi Miller.
Expected me to do. As a kid, everybody wanted me to play sports and have a gusto for field, but my real passion lied in music. And it wasn't until I started doing music that I found what my real passion was. So I learned that, unfortunately, I wasted some time in sports, but it was all worth it because I found music.
Question: humility, integrity, or servanthood? Pick one and tell us why.
I believe integrity is the most important because you can have a servant's heart and still not have good character. And I believe character can take you very far in life no matter what you do.
It's the same one. Humility, and by the way, each is repeated twice. Humility, integrity, or servanthood? Pick one and tell us why.
I would choose servanthood because I believe that Christ calls us to be servants to others. Just as he washed the disciples' feet, so we should serve others. And I have seen many examples of this week from my host family and my driver to Julie and Shane and Hannah and everyone who's made this week possible. They have truly shown how Christ wants us to have a servant's heart.
What one thing is your favorite about who you are?
Sometimes it's really challenging to show your strong faith and let it shine through when you're in a public school system, but having a strong faith can take you very far.
The question, name one quality that makes a woman a strong leader and why?
Confidence is the quality that makes women strong leaders. Many times today, women are told to downplay their strong characteristics, or else to take validation from the opinions that others hold of them. Strong women who want to be leaders must have a vision, and they must have enough confidence in that vision to allow others to believe in it as well.
Same question. Name one quality that makes a woman a strong leader and why?
I believe that resilience is a very powerful trait for a female leader to have. In our society, women are taught to be self-conscious and timid and afraid to speak out. And so, as leaders, we are often challenged and put down. But being resilient allows us to get back up and to keep working and to become those strong leaders that young women look up to.
What's one thing people don't know about you, and why should we?
One thing that people don't know about me initially is that I have an introverted personality. So when you're around me and I feel the need to get off by myself, it doesn't mean that I don't like you. It just means that I need that time to recharge and collect my thoughts so that I can have enough energy to be in social situations again and be pleasant.
What one thing is your favorite about who you are?
I think that the fact that I am personable is my favorite part of my personality. Whether you're a band geek like I am, or if you're a star varsity soccer player, I can find common ground with you and talk to you and have a conversation with you.
regardless of your personality or who you are, I can talk to you, and I think that's my favorite part.
What's one thing people don't know about you, and why should we?
One thing that people do not know about me is where I got my inspiration to be a music therapist. I got my inspiration to be a music therapist from my mother, who discovered that she had a rare genetic cancer when I was just a little girl. Throughout her process, she helped form an international support group where she would meet with people all around the world with the same cancer as her. And as her child, I got to travel to places around the world and meet these people who ultimately inspired me to work with sick people as a music therapist. And I'm really happy to be doing it.
Not much choice there. You know what it is? What did you learn the hard way, and how has it made you wiser?
A lesson that I learned the hard way was to be independent. Being extremely close with my brother made it really hard for me when he left for college, but it really forced me to step out of my comfort zone and finally be able to do things for myself, and this has really shaped me into the person that I am today.
Thank you.
Distinguished Young Woman of Indiana for 2016. Number 22. Travel.